Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. The most violent type of weather storm on planet Earth is a tornado. Meteorologists tell us that the unstable air in a thunderstorm produces updrafts and downdrafts, which interacts with a wind shear to ultimately create a tornado vortex. But many scientists acknowledge that the exact processes that cause a tornado remain mysterious. In recent Space News episodes, Thunderbolts contributor Andrew Hall has explored the electrical genesis of lightning and other earthly weather phenomena. Today, Hall offers his own thesis on the electrical genesis of tornadoes on Earth.
Previously, in Nature's Electrode, we looked at an electric Earth model for lightning genesis driven by a plasma corona formed from condensing and freezing water vapor in the central updraft of a thunderhead. We also looked at the thunderstorm itself and an electric model for the circuit that drives it in the summer thermopile. Now let's consider the most dramatic weather event of all, the tornado, and how these massively destructive whirlwinds are also formed by a plasma corona in a thunderstorm. For air to become plasma and carry current, the air has to be partially ionized. A plasma state can be defined by plasma density, the number of free electrons per unit volume, and the degree of ionization, the proportion of atoms ionized by loss or gain of an electron. A gas with as little as 1% of the particles ionized is a plasma, responding to magnetic fields and displaying high electrical conductivity. A partially ionized plasma is often referred to as a cold plasma, and highly ionized plasma is referred to as hot. Discharge from a corona is predominantly a cold, dark current invisible to the eye. Cloud-to-ground arcs from high charge density regions of the corona surrounding the central updraft where current from the updraft generates ions. Ground charge builds below this region in response, and the electric field strengthens, magnifying and focusing electron avalanche the way a lens focuses light into a continuous plasma channel. When the channel connects with ground and discharges a hot current, it wraps tightly in its own magnetic field, what is called a Z-pinch. But moving away from this self-ionizing high electromagnetic field region of the corona, free electrons spit at the ground, but lack the energy and focus to avalanche all the way, creating instead a mobile cloud of ionized gas that follows the field gradient to ground, generating a dark current. The current is said to drift in this region, yet the electric field still organizes the drifting ions into a columnar channel. In this image, the center of the coronal discharge is focused and imparts more energy to the cascading electrons, creating the potential for lightning arcs. See the current density distribution at the bottom of the diagram. Closer to the outer edge of the corona, weaker reactions manifest in transfer of momentum and heat with ions and neutral matter. Downdraft and downburst winds are the common result. Momentum transfer manifests as downdraft winds by the process of electrokinesis, which is neutral species attracted to and mobilized by the charged particles zooming down the electric field gradient toward the ground, creating an electric wind that moves the bulk fluid along the electric field gradient. If the ionization rate exceeds the rate of recombination, the plasma will build a streamer, a tendril of plasma from cloud to earth, pushing a plasma-generating ionization region ahead of it and drawing behind it a cloud of cold plasma. When this plasma hits ground, a cathode spot is produced, and the electromagnetic field redistributes along the plasma channel, focusing it. The cathode spot on the ground draws positive charge to it, dragging neutrals, again by electrokinesis, and creating the inflowing winds that generate a ground vortex. This is the moment of tornado touchdown, a as charged air and dust flow in and spiral upwards around the invisible plasma tendril. The action is analogous to the lightning bolt leader and positive ground streamer that meet to create a channel for lightning discharge. Two seemingly separate events organized into one coherent structure by the electric field. The plasma current thus created is a complete circuit to ground, only it's partially ionized, diffused with predominantly neutral species. Its energy and charge densities are too low to make an arc, so it forms a complex plasma channel called a Markland convection. Rotation is a natural consequence of the circuit. Neutral air is diffused away from the Markland current, creating low pressure. But positive ions near the ground drag air, dust, and debris to the ground contact and create inflowing winds and a sudden change in direction up and around the tendril. The meeting of these opposing winds is the ground vortex. The current flow in the plasma will itself rotate, taking a helical path as it interacts with the magnetic field around it. The appearance of a tornado is precisely the expected morphology of a Markland current. Increasing current flow will spin up the tornado. It forms an inner spiraling negative current to ground and an outer spiral of positive ionic wind flowing up to the source of coronal discharge in the cloud. Because the tornado is a cold partial plasma current exchanging charge between ground and atmosphere, it can be pushed by winds to create a slanted or kinked path and travel away from its point of origin. There are several telltale signs the electric model of tornado genesis is correct. One evidence is wall clouds. Wall clouds form before a tornado in a typical storm evolution. It develops rotation, and sometimes its clouds can be seen to rise and fall in an agitated manner. Puffs of low-level clouds are drawn to it below the main cloud base. The wall cloud is a physical expression of the corona. As the corona gathers charge, it creates a lowering, vertical wall of cloud as ionization condenses moisture in the column of air below, that is incongruous to the general slant and motion of the storm clouds and inflowing winds. It's visual evidence of a region where the electric field is strengthening and the corona is increasing charge density prior to establishing a current to ground with the tornado. The funnel cloud doesn't always emerge from the center of the wall cloud. The funnel often appears along the edges of the wall cloud or from the surrounding clouds. This is because the region of charge density is mobile and can wander. They can also multiply, creating several tornadoes. Characteristic of parallel currents, multiple tornadoes stand off from each other as if repulsed like two parallel wires flowing current in the same direction. Rare occasions when tornadoes seem to merge, it may be that one simply dies as the other steals its current. The sudden disappearance and reappearance of tornadoes, and the reported skipping or lifting they seem to portray, are likely caused by pulsating current from an unstable coronal discharge that weakens until recombination steals the current, and then revives when the rate of ionization again overcomes the rate of recombination and a complete circuit to ground is reestablished. As discussed in Nature's Electrode and the Summer Thermopile, lightning frequency is highest around the central updraft and increases in frequency with the strength of the updraft wind. When a tornado forms, cloud-to-ground lightning frequency diminishes until the tornado dies, and then picks up again to the previous baseline. It's also found that positive lightning is more common in tornadic storms. The latter is evidence the corona in the storm's anvil that spits positive lightning is instrumental in creating the electric field strength necessary for a tornado. It amplifies the field strength affecting the negative corona in the cloud base below, creating conditions necessary for tornadoes. The fact that cloud-to-ground lightning dissipates as a tornado spins up is evidence the corona is part of a coherent electric circuit, where current in one region robs current from another. Storms that produce tornadoes are often characterized by a greenish tint in the clouds. The green tint is excused by scientists as a reflection of city lights. While their search for green-tinted city lights continues, the dim glow of a coronal discharge internal to the cloud formation explains the green tint. Luminosity in the clouds and the funnel are also reported. Consensus science blames this on misidentified sources of light from lightning, city lights, or flashes from ground power lines. Some of it, no doubt, is, but some of it is likely the effect of coronal discharge. Lightning flashes don't make a continuous glow. Ionized oxygen can recombine to produce ozone, which has a distinctive chlorine-like gassy smell. This smell is often reported by witnesses. So are hissing sounds from the base of the funnel. Funnel clouds and small tornadoes are known to produce harmonic sounds of whistling, whining, humming, or buzzing bees. As ozone is liberated, it produces such a hissing sound. Energized transmission lines, subject to overvoltage conditions, produce all of these same effects. Faint luminescent glow, ozone production, and its accompanying hiss and smell. The cause is coronal discharge. Tornadoes also produce identifiable infrasound. It's inaudible to the human ear, but it can be felt. It will produce nausea, agitation, and body heat, effects often felt in the presence of tornadoes, although fear might do that too. Lightning has been reported internal to the funnel, and these may be a form of cloud-to-cloud discharge between the counterflowing positive and negative currents in the Markland convection. Tornadoes are seen to have an inner and outer column, although this is disputed by consensus scientists as an illusion. The inner column, however, is seen if the outer dusty sheath dissipates or is blown away. It is consistent with the double wall formation in a Markland convection. Tornadoes emit on the electromagnetic spectrum as measured by researchers. Tornadoes emit spherics, which is the same type of broadband radio noise lightning discharges produce. So what if there is no supercell? How do all other vortex phenomena form, like land spouts and water spouts, gustnadoes and dust devils? And how are they related? Well, by the same mechanism proposed here for the supercell tornado, only in lower energy form. Funnel clouds, which never result in a touchdown, are a tendril of Markland convection current that begins to recombine faster than it generates ions, and it dies. Land spouts, gustnadoes, and water spouts all begin with a surface disturbance, a vortex without a cloud, or at least not one showing a wall cloud or rotation. These are instances of stronger ionic accumulation at ground level, creating a strong ground vortex first in easily ionized sand or water, whereas the corona above is still weak and diffuse. This comports with observations of twisters of all kinds, including dust devils and spouts, which are seen to begin on the ground, or water in the case of a water spout, where documented evolution begins with a mysterious dark spot on the water. Thunderstorms, lightning, and tornadoes, all products of the same weather event, can be perfectly modeled electrically. Electromagnetic fields, ionization, current, capacitance, and induction rule nature. It is evident in nature's every aspect because the fractal self-same patterns always appear. Consensus science adheres to a gravity model that ignores this fundamental causation and instead feverishly dissects the emergent thermodynamic and fluid dynamic interactions looking for answers, like trying to tell time by taking apart the clock. They continually come up short as a result. Thank you.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.